Good morning, students. We are going to do the first chapter of the book Vistas, the third level. This story is written by Jack Finney. This story is a science fiction and it talks about a travel into time. Jack Finney was an American author. His best known works are science fiction and thrillers, including The Body Snatcher, Time and Again. His original name was Walter Braden Finney, was born in Milwaukee. Now we talk about the summary of the story. The story deals with the curious experience of a 31-year-old man, Charlie, a daily commuter. That means a person who used the train from a particular station to reach his office and to come back home, who reaches the third level while taking the subway. At this station, there were different levels, the first level and the second level. Now, one day he reaches the third level while taking the subway. Everyone thought there were only two levels. Everyone, when he went and told about the third level to his family and friends, everyone thought that they had seen only the two levels. So, how is Charlie talking about the third level? At the Grand Central Station, but Charlie knew that there was a third level. And according to him, if one could discover that third level could be transported to 1894. Now he discovered that at this third level, if a person reaches this third level, he can be transported to the year 1894. The third level was something similar to the narrator's imagination. Now this narrator was tired of his life in this 20th century and he wanted something of the past, just before the World War, where everything was simple, quiet and nice. He wanted a life of that kind and he imagined a life of. So when he described about this level, about the third level and the people and the life of 1894, everyone thought that he's imagining things. It is a journey back to time and an intersection of time and space. Now this, coming to the third level and what he sees there, the station, the train, the people, the way they are dressed, all belonging to the past age, it was something kind of, everyone thought it to be a kind of imagination for Charlie. And this seemed to be an intersection of time and space. What does intersection of time and space mean? That though he was in the present time in the 20th century, he could travel back into the 1894s. This was what his travel. That means his body is in this age, but yet he could travel back. So this was the space traveling. It is seen that Charlie's medium of escape from the pulse and pressure of life. And this seems to be like Charlie's medium of escape. He is tired of his life. He is of this all the crowd and the noise and all. He wants something quiet and nice. So people think that he is imagining about this third level. The third level is mysterious world that is somewhere between our unfulfilled desires, expectations and dreams. This third level, what is a desire, unfulfilled desire, expectations and our dreams, the place that we want to go in. And this third level, where everything was quite nice, clean, belonging to the past, seems to be a kind of expectation. It is a point of no escape, where the time, dimension, the past, the present and the future does not exist. At this third level, the past, the present and the future does not exist. Which means that though he is living in the 20th century, but he can travel to the 18th and the 19th century. Now, this was the story here. The characters are Charlie, a 31-year-old daily commuter, accidentally arrives at the third level of the Grand Central Station and experiences a whole new world there. His wife, Lucia, every day Charlie is coming late home and she is worried about his coming late. Then the third character is Sam. He is a psychiatrist of Charlie who serves as a proof the existence of the third level at the Grand Central Station. Now, Sam is a psychiatrist friend of Charlie who does not believe that Charlie has really seen something. He thinks that Charlie is imagining. He thinks that Charlie is in a world of hallucination and imagination. But once he gets a chance to go to the third level, he catches a train and goes into the past. And his going into the past is a proof that third level does exist. Both Lucia and Charlie, that is Charlie's wife and his psychiatrist, feel that he is losing grip of reality. Lucia, Charlie's wife and Sam, they feel that Charlie is no more in the reality. He is living somewhere in the past. It seemed Charlie longed to do in reality but could not. Sam said that this was a moment of escapism for Charlie. Now he wanted to, he longed for something. He longed for a world that was quiet and nice, a world that was in the past, but he could not do it. It was his longing which made him see things, hallucinate things, and it was a way to escape from everyday problems of life, the stress of life, the problems of the modern world. And he said that this is escapism. Sam said that this is escapism for Charlie, because through this third level he was trying to escape from his own life, modern life, problems of modern life, into a past life which was very quiet and nice. Like collecting stamp was a temporary refuge for reality. Like collecting stamp also was getting away from the reality and going into past. The stamps which were of the old days, of the past days, it was related to this escapism that through the stamp collecting, he is not in his present, but he is in a way he is trying to escape into a world that no longer exists. The narrator introduces him, Charlie, as an ordinary guy. While taking the twist and the turns, went down the steps to the first level, then the author goes down the stairs, he reaches the third level of the Grand Central Station. The basic structures at the third level was different. The room was smaller. When he goes to the third level, he normal, like everyday normal, he goes to the station, crosses from the first level to the second level. He does not realize that he is going to a different level. When he comes to the third level, then he finds that it is very quiet. There's nobody there. And while walking on that third level, he could hear his own footsteps. And the lamppost, the people there, the information booth, the way they were dressed up, the fashion of that age, it did not match with the 20th century, but seemed to be somewhere in the past. Clothes and everything. The locomotive, the train that came there, it also belonged to the past era. He felt that he had been transported to 1890s. Now, he went to buy, so he wanted to catch a train and leave that place and go to whatever place it takes, the train, whatever place it takes him. So he went to buy the ticket for himself and for Lucia. And what happens there? He wanted to go to the old era, Illinois. But the clerk did not accept the currency. The currency that he was giving was the modern currency of the 20th century, which did not exist in the 18th century. So this clerk and this booking office belonged to the 1890s. So they did not accept, the clerk there did not accept the currency of the 20th century. And he thought that Charlie is trying to cheat him by showing him this money which did not belong to that era. Next day, he does not go back home. So he could not buy the ticket, he goes back home. Next day, he goes to a shop, an old style, and exchanges some old style currency. He pays a high money for it, a big amount for it, and buys some old currency to buy the ticket. He goes down the corridor, he goes to the station, he goes down to the corridor through the different passages and all, but he cannot find the third level. Every day he is trying to go find the third level, but he could not reach the third level. Soon he forgets about it. Soon he forgets about this third level and he goes back to his stamp collecting. This stamp collecting was also kind of escaping from his reality, from his real world, and going back to something which was in the past. One night, while he was going through the first day covers of his grandfather. His grandfather used to collect the first day covers. He was going through them and he finds a strange envelope there. He opens it and he finds a letter from his psychologist friend, Sam, saying that he had found the third level and was in Galesburn doing a business in feed and grain. Now, he finds a letter. It is his grandfather's collection. He had gone through it so many times, but he had never found that letter. But today, when he goes through it again, he finds that the letter is addressed to his grandfather, but the envelope is addressed to his grandfather, but the letter is for him. And he opens this letter and he finds that this letter is from his friend Sam, who says that he had discovered the third level and he has gone back to Galesburn, which existed in 1894, and he is doing a business in feed and grain. He was very happy in the past era as he always wanted to do this work. He could not practice psychiatry in 1894, and he said that he cannot practice his psychiatry because in 1894 no one knew about psychiatry and no one needed it. So he is doing a business in grain and in the feed, cattle feed and all that. So this is the story here. This is a story which is a science fiction which tells us about the time travel. Might be there will come a time when this will also be a reality, that people can travel from past to present and to future. Now here we are talking about the intersection of time and space. It has been discussed here. Reduced to nothing. The time and space have been reduced to nothingness. There's nothing like time. There's nothing like space. All the barriers related to time and space are broken. Why? Because Charlie bumps into third level of 1894 and returns to the 20th century. Similarly, Sam reaches Galesburg in 1894 and still can contact Charlie in the 20th century, which convincingly brings about that there is an intersection of time and space in the story. I hope the summary has been clear. Thank you very much.